Evening, everybody. All right. Where is this guy going? Pardon me. Pardon me. Hello again. Hello. Well, 97 and queen e4 wins the pawn, but I kind of want this pawn instead. So let me get this pawn. Okay. Okay, I like this move. No, but you... Alright. Alright, gentlemen. Back in business. Hello, Mr. Mighty. Marp, IG lad. John Spartan X is following. Thank you. Damn. Yeah, tactics, man. You have time. Think. Use it. The first thing you should always do is check what is it that your opponent wants to do. Always. If you're only focusing on your own plans, you're setting yourself up for a constant surprise party. Alright? Let's put it that way. Yeah, I like this move. I agree. I think it's good. I think this move is good. Arnau Sanchez Aguila. My god, those long Spanish names, they're gonna kill me one day. Is it a Spanish name? Or is it just Latin? Ah, okay. Alright. Welcome to the channel, sir. See, in chess, I always like my pieces, especially in Fish Random Chess, to be playing from the get-go. So ideally, if your bishop are on the long diagonal, you should really open those bishops. With the knights, it's a little bit more complicated because you need to know where these knights are going, right? Knights can go to so many different places. But it looks like we're gonna get a lot of central squares here. Is it good? Is it bad? I don't know. Let's finish the development. I like pawns first, knights second approach. Yes, this is Fischer Chess. This is how you castle in Fischer Random Chess, I agree. Alright, so knight d6, that's what I was talking about. Maybe I like this knight here instead of f6, so that my bishop is not closed. And now that the white declared his king, I can actually think, should I stay here, should I castle, or should I castle short side, right? Questions. Questions that need to be answered. Now that the white king is here, I think I should go b5 and go for the attack, to be honest. Especially with the rook here, right? I think it would be a shame not to go for c4, b4 and go for this action here. And compare our queens, right? Look at white queen. It's completely circumcised or circumscribed by its own pawns, right? or subscribed. Oh my god. Jesus. Anyway, I can never get this word right. The positions of the places. Ah, okay. As we noticed before, right? When you have rook and bishop and queen all looking for attention, you know, they will get that attention. Okay. This is probably a good move. However, what happens if I play... okay, knight a5, say. I actually want a castle first, before going for any interaction. Unauthorized interaction. Okay, knight a5. Seems reasonable. Potentially, black has bishop c6 take on a4 idea, but right now we are interested in this pawn on b3. Very, very closely. We're very interested in this pawn. Very, very interested. Grab. And there is this idea, either bishop e4 or knight b5, and I don't know which one should I go for. I really like knight b5 idea, to be honest, with the idea of knight a3. But I also do like bishop e4 idea. There is also potential sacrifice on b3, but it's not checkers. White will not accept probably my sacrifice. I do like knight b5 idea. You know, we are starting to get to the squares that have been liberated by the exchange of the bishop. Good night. Good night, Mr. the Yonky Yonky one. Good night, sir. Alright, grab. The grab looks decent. Maybe I was a little bit too optimistic about my position, yeah? I thought I had clear advantage, but I don't see it anymore. Alright, so I misplayed my position. Probably knight a3 should have been played. And then e5, just get rid of this knight, yeah? Yeah, okay. Miscalculation. Alright, miscalculation on my part. Miscalculation on my part. Damn, I play this game very strongly. The end game is played absolutely brilliantly, Mr. Aruru. I'm very proud of you, sir. Thank you. but you're giving me too many pawns, sir. Too many pawns. Although it might be good, yeah. Damn. I thought I was winning here. One of those funny positions, yes. All right. Why was stream restarted? I thought everyone went to sleep. No. I said that we're gonna start a new tournament soon. And I'll be back. Yes, Mr. Aruru. You missed the win completely there. I'll probably miss the win also, but that's what happens, yeah? That H5 was a big lemon. Yes. You were better deaf. but you came very, very close, sir. I think you were much worse in the opening, but then I made some inaccuracies and you outplayed me. And I'm very proud of you, sir. Yeah, when I have knights like this, I try to put them here. Yeah, I like this idea. The bells of Notre Dame, they're ringing and ringing. Yep, correctly noticed. One problem with my setup is this. interesting. I don't like long c5. Opening the file, in this case, I'm perfectly happy with this because I get the center. So what else am I missing? First time you're close to beat me. Awesome, man. I'm very happy. Yes, you were. Yes, you were. Yes, you were, dude. I totally agree. What are the keys to play good 960 chess? Same thing in classical chess. Developments, noticing the opportunity, and and looking for good places for your pieces. Everything that makes you a good chess player remains true in Fischer Random Chess. The rules are the same. The rules are the same, gentlemen. There is no trick. This is not a trick. See, Batinik, he just completely... disregarded his bishops here, especially the bishop on h8. And now he's paying a price. You guys see it, right? It's valuable for intermediate players to play gambits to learn how to play with initiative. Yes, it is important. Yes. You should play all different positions. It's not only for intermediate players, it's for everybody. You should play complex positions. You should play positions with... dynamic play with closed positions. You have to learn to play everything. You have to play, you know, learn how to play everything, man. It's no joke. It's no joke, sir. Karakamsky lives in the Dracula castle. I don't know about that, man. Just make sure that the bishop never comes out. I'm just making sure this bishop is permanently retired. Yeah, so avoid getting such positions, okay? Avoid at any cost. Make sure all your pieces are playing, at least in the game. Mr. Batini, hopefully you learned this. Yes, I know, but okay, when the position is completely winning like this, you don't have to rush, yeah? Yes, Mr. Rurik, Queen B7 was a simple win. I'm not sure it was that simple. I don't think it was that simple, but I'm glad that you noticed it. Yeah, I mean, pinning is important. Again, remember how we always say pinning for winning, right? Alright. Yes, this is one of those positions where after b6 check, bishop a6 check, suddenly you have only one possible move to defend against the check on the second move in Fischer Random Chess. Alright, this is a Fischer Random Chess for you, yes. Alright, how do you develop? I don't know. Yes, I hate these positions with the bishop in the center here, like this. Yeah. Surprisingly, we can play Spanish game, yeah? And then you have bishop b5. Yeah, that kind of is actually funny. Although it's not exactly a Spanish game, but... yeah, surprisingly, you can make classical chess moves. There's no command like that here, sir. Sorry. But there is command where you can go for title. And... Ah! It's bugged. Okay. It is bugged. Alright, sorry. Okay, I'll have to change it. Let me go to Twitch. And change it. Because that 90 minutes just screwed things up big time. Edit stream info. Alright, let's... Arena. Let's change it. And now this should definitely look better. Yeah, now you can join the tournament if you are a subscriber, sir. And this is almost like a true Spanish, yeah? Almost. Kind of like these positions. The kings are back in the center, which they should be. big blunder on my part. Yep. Good eye, Mr. Nietzsche Chess. Very good eye. Yeah, I knew that b5 was a little bit suspicious, but I didn't realize it was that bad. Okay. Oops. Yeah, I'm getting killed here. Yeah, I do want to give you this line. I don't really want to give this line. Advantage, white, extra pawn. Technically winning position. Do you think Daniel Nordinsky has a chance to reach 2700 in the near future? Sure. Of course he has a chance. Of course Daniel has the chance. He always had. He always had that chance. I think it's probably the hardest to get to 2600. And then, like, you know, when you're playing esports, right, you're stuck at a certain level and then you're starting to believe you'll never reach that level. Like, I'm being stuck in the silver 4 level for a month now. And I can never get out, and I'm starting to think I'm, like, really so bad that, you know, I can reach the higher level. Yeah. And so it's nice to have an encouragement of sorts. It's always nice to have an encouragement, gentlemen. Someone to just tell you that you're doing okay. Yeah, you're gonna make it. I think that's important. No Counter-Strike. I'm playing League. Because I see a lot of chess players, they play League. So I sort of resurrected my some of my accounts. And decided to keep going at it. I also play, even though I love card games, like Legends of Runeterra, it is just such a big matter of luck, yeah? You're gonna get a counter deck or not, or if you're gonna get the right card in the correct sequence or not, right? There are, like, so many things beyond your control. So it's, you know, those card games are probably worse than poker, to be honest. Yeah, I play the games I like. I do. Yeah. Also, I think games like action games are very good for you to take off your stress, right? So you don't kill people in real life, yeah? If you're mad, upset, something, you know, you go and take it off, take some of that steam off in some video sport game. Although it is debatable. It is debatable. I agree. It is debatable. Yeah, but Nietzsche Chess is, yeah, I think he cares for this bishop on c4 too much, yeah? If he just plays bishop f1 and knight c4, and starts hitting my weaknesses, I'm, like, dead. Yeah, so I'm very happy that he is not killing me immediately. Alright, so 96. Maneuvering game. It's a maneuvering game now. My viewership is mainly 30 years old. Who cares about League? No. My viewership is not 30 years old. Who cares about League? My God. No. My viewership are the people who care about the Spice Girls and stuff like that. Alright, let's bring the Kingo. Hey, you're 23. I'm happy for you, man. Yeah. Yeah. We're discussing some old hot singers, female singers of yesterday. And not only singers. All right. Oh, we got the... Oh, shit. Oh, I forgot. This is exactly the reason why you play Bishop D2. Good job, man. I was too busy trying to think of the names of these singers. I missed this tactic. Yeah, Mr. Nietzsche Chess, I think you got your first win over me, yeah? Probably. I think this is probably his first win over me. It's not gonna be that easy. It's a big fight, yeah? It's a big fight. I have a little bit more experience. So that definitely helps me. I agree. Bad move, but okay. No, that was even worse. Alright. Let's just trade this bishop. Alright, I think I have for you a draw. You deserve a draw. This guy deserves a draw. He was completely winning. My god, Mark! Mark just caught Andromeda discussing girls. Wow. Mark, perfect timing, man. Alright. Perfect timing. Yeah, good. yeah, we're playing Fischer Random Chess. I'm trying to teach guys, you know, Fischer Chess is more about close positions, and that's exactly what Andromeda is playing. He likes close positions. So we're giving him more close positions. It's also very dynamic. Yeah. He is banned. Mark is raiding. Oh, he did? Oh, I'm sorry. Did I miss the raid? Oops. Bad me. What? No. It was just one man raid by Rambo Mark. Okay. Thank you. Thanks, man. Alright, probably the first to go active is the one to get the spoils, yeah. Alright, 93. Which role do you play in League? I have to play everything. I have to learn to play everything because the outer field puts you into any role. Ah. Are you on the tennis court after practice? I see. Yeah. Mark, what do you think of the last Rambo movie? I mean, it's Stallone, right? He's the iconic dude. But yeah. I don't know, man. Not the Expendables. No, no, no. The Rambo, the last Rambo movie. It's about the way he goes to Mexico, right? Okay. Like the one in Cambodia. Yeah, for sure. Okay. Yeah, I believe you. Yeah. I used to like Dolph Lundgren movies, the way he plays Russian. Yeah, they always cast him as a Russian. Also incredibly funny. I mean, it's such a stereotype for a Russian, even though I don't think there are many Russians who look like Dolph Lundgren. Is the best Russian player right now after Jan Nepomniachtchi? Well, he just lost to Dubov today, right, guys? Wasn't it Nepo who lost to Dubov today? It was a very one-sided affair, too. I was like, damn. Can you guys believe Dubov made Nepo look like a baby, yeah? After this game. And Nepo is one of the leading players in the world. Yeah, I think Dubov is really, really, really Lev Polugayevsky reincarnated, to be honest. Reincarnated Lev Polugayevsky, who was among the most dangerous players. With his opening preparations. Okay. All right, this is the part where this music always gets stuck. Yeah, so I have to change it. Yeah, he made Naka look like that too. Yes. You really enjoyed Krasbook's stream. Commentary strong. Correct. Correct. Krasbook is a very famous Russian commentator. If you really want to learn both your Russian and some chess skills, and understanding of the chess mentality, the way the Russians do it, yeah, he's very good to listen to. He was also the commentator for my World Cup in 2007, which I was lucky enough to win. And that's how I know him. And not the least, the fact that at the tournament, you know, because it's an international tournament, right? It was organized in Ханты-Мансийск, so they organized this. They always invited some local girls translators, which are going to the university, all right? So, and those girls had to be present in the press room all the time, you know, in case there are foreign journalists asking questions. They don't know Russian, right? So, some interesting memories from that event, for sure. Shipov? That's from the Krasbook. Yes, the commentator. Yeah, that's Krasbook. He's the same guy. Oh my god, look at this position with the queen on a1 and queen on a8. My god. It looks like it's game over, yeah? Look at this queen a2 move, sneaky move. Yes. Hello, Mr. Quadras Paz. Yes, look at this position. This is looks like 1-0. In classical chess, this position would be like 1-0. But in Fish Random Chess, it's unclear. Alright. In Twitch Chess, you have faith in me. Great, thanks. You're my boy Blue? What? 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 Come on, man. I'm 46 years old. How can I be anybody's boy now? Unless you're like 70, yeah? All right. Yeah, we do have some 70-year-old people here. We do have some 70-year-old gentleman people on our channel. Some of them are even 80, I believe. Yeah. People who have grandkids. Yeah, and they still play chess. And I'm not sure if that is because of this Elizabeth Harmon TV show or not. So I'm not convinced that it was that show by itself that brought such a huge... Alright, hold on a second. What is this? I have an interesting idea. Let's try it. F5. It looks very, very interesting. Oh, but you play E5. Ugh. Ugh. E5 is ugh. All right, grab the pawn. Looks like Benoni reversed. Yeah, Benoni on the other side of the board though. Or even Alekhine. Yeah, looks like that a little bit. Yeah, okay, let's play bishop h6, preventing castling, right? It's kind of important. Damn, I'm older than Gara. I'm not sure if that deserves an exclamation mark or not, but it's nice that there are some people who are the same age as me. Alright, tactics! Hello, tactics! Welcome to the club. Now, there's only one move, right? Otherwise, you lose the bishop. Two moves, okay. I didn't consider knight takes b2 as the move, because it just loses the bishop on f4 and gives black too much. Zoomers, rise up. I wish I was a pensioner. I don't know, do you really wish to be pensioner? I don't know, what do the pensioners in the USA they receive these days from the Social Security, you guys know? Anybody knows? What is the current Social Security payout for the pension? Probably they have those, I remember they had those huge, huge differences between plans, right? So it also matters, like, which line of work you were. Ah. That kind of pensioner, okay, I see. That kind of pensioner. $41,000? Ah. She just cooked sweets and fattened you up? My god, that doesn't sound right, man. Fattening up people, that just doesn't sound right. I'm sorry, it just doesn't sound right. Small trick, I guess, by white. However, if I play queen c4 here... What is it that I'm blundering? Sweets, yeah, sweets is nice, but too much sugar can kill you, yeah? I mean, my mom is a diabetic, so that means I'm at risk also. Sounds like an Eastern European grandma. All right, Mr. My balls was shot. Tell us about your grandma kind. Your kind of grandma. What is your grandma kind? With butter and sugar signs. Ah, it can kill your brain. Okay. Same? Ah. Well. Uh-huh. You heard literally. Well. Okay. Yeah. Too much sugar is really bad. That I know. I don't know many things, but that I do know, that too much sugar is bad. Alright, queen a5, no move repetition. Well, the whole idea behind this maneuver is to get my queen from g8 to the queen side, so I can finally play a retarded move like this. And then do this thing with the gusto, yeah? And then boom, my rook is in the game suddenly. Are you trying to escape? There is no escape. There is no escape, sir. No escape is allowed. No way, Jose. Check. Damn. You really escape, yeah? Okay, but you escape, but you're gonna have to leave your stuff behind. Alright, retarded moves are good. It can be a useful move. Yeah, you should consider all sorts of candidate moves, guys. Even the retarded ones, because sometimes it's retarded move that wins the game, because it is so freaking retarded, right? It can be just so impossible that it is just could be the winning move. Milk in England is like half water. Uh-huh. They put sugar in milk in England, it's everywhere. Oh my god. I see. And half water milk is best for tea. Proper milk. Wow. Alright, so we see some interesting cultural things. Great. Derek Lewis? I have no idea who you guys are talking about. I have no idea. You lost me right there. Alright, where am I gonna put my bishop? Where's this fella going? Maybe we should play London system, right? I win a bunch of moves, actually. By developing bishop on h2, having London system bishop here. Instead of playing bishop f4 h2, I can play bishop h2 immediately. Damn. I like that. Alright. Mission step 1 accomplished. We got our London bishop on h2. Ah, but we have the pawn on c4. Damn. That's not good. That is not good. No. It's fine. Guys, I love food just like you do. I think good food is very important. It's also very important to find the good woman in your life. I think it's pretty much critical. Yeah. Yeah, my king is feeling the heat, yeah? Is black really gonna castle this way? Are you really gonna do that? Are you gonna do that to me? Alright, I'm just gonna play knight f3. Hope you play e4 and open my bishop. Which is nothing wrong with that, but... stand down and accept the truth. And what is the truth? You're sounding like that kid from the Matrix first, right? Remember that kid who looked like a little Buddha? Right, and then he says, you have to accept the truth, and then he says, blah, 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 blah. And something with a spoon, right? Drinking 6 to 10 cups of double tea bag tea caffeine was responsible. Just swipe right often enough? Well, that's debatable, yeah? That's debatable, man. That's debatable. Alright, make sure we cover our bases, right? So this is like English or what? I like how black develops here. Alright, fine, let's play d4. We actually tricked you. Yeah, we waited for the bishop e6 so we can play d5 now. All right. There is no spoon. Okay. Oh yeah. That's the guy. All right. Sometimes you put chili in your tea. Is that good? Is that a good thing? I hope it is good. Okay, so if I take here, then g4, g3, you take with the check, so I have to take with the knight, yeah? Alright, so that means I have to take with the knight. No, you closed my bishop! You closed my London bishop! How dare you to close my London bishop? You're bad. You're naughty. What did my London bishop ever do to you? It was such a nice bishop. My god. My poor London bishop on h2. Rest in peace, yes? Damn, man. This cruel man just completely annihilated my bishop. Yes. Good job, though. Good job, man. Good job. But we're not done yet. You know, there was this famous Russian cartoon. It was called Капитан Врунгель. Или путешествие Капитан Врунгель. It's the travels of Капитан Врунгель. And it featured a character which was supposedly evil Mr. Fox. Who liked to say Mr. Fox has 80 different options in his plan. So he played this role of an evil genius, yeah? It was like Moriarty of whatever. It was like Moriarty anyway. Okay. Looking good. Looking good now. I'm very happy. All your pawns are on the dark squares. That means potentially bishop is coming to get you, man. That bishop is coming to get you. Ah, but you're coming to develop your bishop as well, yeah? Hmm. Okay, I see. Nice, nice. Yeah, this is nice. Alright, fine. Are foxes evil in all countries? Yeah, that's actually a good question. Are foxes evil in all countries? I'm not sure. We should ask... there are some people who have a college degree in children or young adult education, right? And once I took actually class, and when I was in college, it was English for young adults. And we were basically... The whole semester, what we were doing... We were reading fairy tales and discussing their significance or the symbolism in those fairy tales and how they apply. Okay, king d2. And quickly c5. Yeah. We go for a quick c5. Maybe it's not good though. Yeah, so that was the class. Hello from Wales. Damn, we have a lot of English dudes here. Greetings. Yeah, and I'm very tempted to ask how is the Brexit going, but I'm not, because I'm not a politician. yeah, sorry. I don't want to... I don't want to really rub it in, yeah? Yeah. Sorry. Knight h4. I thought you're gonna play knight e7, try to get to my pawn, but if you play knight h4, I'm very happy because that means my a pawn is starting its journey. The journey without destination. Wait, you could have played queen c4, yeah? Why didn't you play it, man? Queen c4 just win, no? Alright, maybe you don't win, but it's close enough. Alright, fine, 93 looks also strong enough. I agree. This looks strong enough. Are there significant checks? Yes, they are. Ugh. This does look good. Yeah, this does look good, gentlemen. I probably lost this game. No, but you just gave me a whole pawn for nothing. Oh, the fantastic gifts. Thank you for your gift. Always grab the pawn. Oh, you're happy with the draw, right? All right. You're very happy with the draw. I understand. All right. Are we happy with the draw? We're probably okay with it. All right, good job. How for your draw, sir? Alright, not bad. You made a lot of people angry. Yeah, sorry. Yes. Is the king and pawn ending a draw? No, because my a pawn is too close to the promotion, right? And the c6 pawn takes away the b7 square. Black cannot black cannot exchange the queens, right? So that was correct. Just black made a draw, though he was completely winning a few moves before. Yeah, because he could just give me check on c4, I think, and that was game over. Probably he was afraid of check on f6 something, but I don't know, I don't see it. So. Oh my god, if I play knight b6, knight c5, I lose the pawn immediately. Oh my god. Really? Really, Fischer Random Chess. Sometimes it does give you positions like that. Crazy positions. I would say even impossible positions like that. What they do? You smile and you pretend that everything is cool. That's what you do. You're exhausted, you cannot get into the Fischer Random Arena. Good night. Alright, good night, Mr. Punctilifron. Thank you so much for staying with us. Alright, I'll take your pawns. I will take your pawns. Ah, but I lost my castling rights. Yeah, okay, fine. That's fine. I mean, look at my bishop on g8, yeah, mighty, in despair. Yeah. I'm serious, this is a mighty bishop, guys. You just don't know it yet. I mean, he probably doesn't know it yet, but he will learn. This bishop is mighty. Alright, then that sounds like a celebration party, for sure. Alright, where's my queen going? My god, this bishop is good and bad at the same time. Alright, fine, let's do this unthinkable move. I absolutely hate this move, but I think I need to develop finally. That's why I'm playing it, because I need to finish the development. Because my rook moved, right? I can't castle queenside. It's terrible. That is terrible. Okay. Thank you. You're welcome, Mr. Ruru. Thank you so much. Thank you for your cheering. Thank you for your support. We got a lot of raids today, by the way, guys. So I'd like to say thank you for those viewers who decided to stay after the raids and join the party. Thank you so much. I think e4 was very interesting. Maybe white is even winning after that move. If you allow my bishop to get to e4, look at that bishop, right? It does become a mighty bishop. I promised you a mighty bishop, right? And finally, we castle. And we're getting the mighty bishop. And if we get the chance to get the second mighty bishop here, we're absolutely happy. Alright, so what's going on? How did you feel when you reached 2700 for the first time? It didn't feel like anything, man. It was just normal stuff. I didn't care about ratings or chess at the time. I was just doing it because my dad was pressing me. The only time I think it all changed was when he finally realized that... you know, he should let me just, you know, be more myself and give me more freedom. And that was the first time when I felt like a human being. Without needing to win anything. Check looks good. All right, so extra pawn for black. Good chances for white. Kind of like knight c2 more. Because the king really... I'm not sure where the king belongs. Yeah, it's hard to say, to be honest. I didn't learn chess. Again, one of the things that my father taught me is chess. It's kind of funny in a way how it all started. Yeah, he was basically looking for my future profession where I can be famous. Where I can be famous, okay? So he opened the way I could be famous and not get hit on the head because he was a boxer, right? He was hit a lot on the head and he didn't want me to be hit on the head. All right, we have 19 players actually in our tournaments. We have some new players. Awesome, we have veterans. Awesome. All right, guys. Okay, Mr. Rura, good night, good day, depends on where you live, sir. Alright, so, suggestions, you guys want more time in the future, or you want less time, do you want increments, no increments? Do you like Fischer Random Chess at all? I absolutely love Fischer Random Chess. Oh, Colombia, okay. Yes, I think I'm absolutely sure I would have had a different career if not for my father. However, if you're asking me if suddenly I had a choice in the matter after I started studying chess, if I would have a different career after I learned chess, then the answer would probably would be no, because as I mentioned before, my first coach was Vladimir Grigorievich Zak, right? He was the coach for Spassky and Korchnoi. And he really sort of got to me in terms of, in a good way, right? Wow. Yeah, he understood what the kid needs, what the kid needs, right? And he put no pressure on me. And he introduced me to some children classic books, and I was very happy. Yeah. I mean, he treated me very nicely. And then he, not many guys know about this. Okay, I will tell you guys because it just came across my memory. But when I was a young kid, yeah, he actually wrote me a book where he says to the future world champion. All right. I know that a lot of coaches do stuff like that. But, you know, that was kind of nice, to be honest. You think 3+2 is perfect? Okay. Yeah, but it's sort of like it's encouraging the kid, right? It's very encouraging. He realizes, you know, people actually believe into him. They, you know, believe in his abilities, despite whatever anybody thinks. The symmetry ends here. I'm not sure if some of you guys remember. There was this very old game. Very, very old game. I was a big fan of X-Men, and there was this old game, arcade game. It was called Children, X-Men Children of the Atom. I know a lot of people hated this. I hated this game, but, you know, I still kind of like it. It was kind of cool. And then it became very cool, especially once you learned that there is Akuma as a hidden character in the game, right? You have to press a certain combination to get him to appear. And he was pretty badass in that game. When he gave me a little bit more freedom, the first time when he gave me a little bit more freedom, I was 18. It was just a tiny more. And as soon as he gave me that freedom, you know, I said to him, okay, I need help. If you want me to become the world champion, I really need help. I cannot do it myself, all right? So I told him, if you want me to be really the champion that you want me to be, then I need help. That's what I told him. That's when the whole saga started, where he invited the Grandmaster Jinji Hashvili and Shabalov to stay in our place. Well, so that's when it started. And that's when, ladies and gentlemen, started the candidates, the famous run in the PCA and the FIDE. Right? Everybody knows about it. But not when it would actually cause that run to happen. How many world champions have I played against? I played against a lot of guys. I feel very honored to play against all these world champions, to be honest. It's a huge privilege, guys. It's a huge privilege. When people you were reading about only in the books, right, you get to meet them. Alright, bishop f3 was really a bad move. I should have put probably the knight on f3 to g5. I mean, black probably can survive this, yeah. It's kind of funny, but I think black survives this, so... Yeah, because my knight on d2 really is not doing much. So let's put this guy somewhere where he'll be busy doing something good. Yes, PCA Professional Chess Association, that is correct. Alright, I can do that too. So we're playing a waiting game because black pieces are still sort of tied up, right? Neither of the knights can move. So I'm looking for ways to try to use it to my advantage. Except I don't really know, but let's try it. This little cunning move. The idea is obvious, but the solution is not obvious by far. The solution is not obvious by far. The idea was that it was a double attack, right? Because now I can take this pawn. And now we have extra pawn, which is very important. Very, very important. Those little extra pawns, they decide the course of the game. And then immediately everything starts to fall, right? Black's entire camp is falling. Okay. All right, not bad. Matt Gross, not bad, but you gave me a little bit too much, yeah? No, never. Never. Never push your kids. I don't think that's correct. I mean, it's a good idea to encourage them, but to... I mean, there's certain things you should do, right? Sometimes... it's always a tough choice, right? When you know when your kid is going to do the wrong thing and you know it's absolutely wrong, but he doesn't, you know, you understand that he doesn't understand it's wrong, and you understand that he will not be able to learn that it is wrong until he reaches maturity, right? So there are some things that people have to learn on their own, and the hardest thing for the parent is probably just to allow the kid to go for it and learn those things the hard way. But unfortunately, that's life. Sometimes you play a move like c5 to make sure this bishop does not get... this is Fischer Random Chess. And in Fischer Random Chess, it's important to keep stuff like this in mind, okay? Let's put it this way. Okay. C4 doesn't look necessary, but looks okay. Well, I want to take with rook here, actually. Well, I could be wrong. Did my children play chess? Difficult question. Yeah, it also depends a lot on the on what a child is like, right? Every kid is unique. There is no magic. I recall there were some movies, yeah? Some movies which basically proclaim, like, there are devices, yeah? Devices that can tell you what you're good at. Both the children and the adults. Famous, legendary... storytelling. Alright, I think this is a pretty strange position. I think black might be actually doing okay, yeah. Knight b4, interesting. Trying to get rid of the weakness. That sounds good, yes. Sounds very good. Still trying to get to that pawn of yours. But I think the battle, I lost this battle, yeah. I think I lost this battle. When is Andromeda getting banned? What do you mean getting banned? Why would he get banned? Andromeda is awesome. He's an awesome dude. Why would he want to ban Andromeda? Yeah. This is not the good way to play chess because you double your rooks. Now your rooks have no squares because of a knight blocking the pawn. Starting to make this rook look really bad. It was much better placed on the d-file. And of course, one of the things in such positions, guys, the grandmaster would always try to undermine this pawn chain. So you're fighting only against one pawn, not two. Okay, bishop e2. The rook is going to the central file. Yeah, okay. Somebody's listening. Good. Right. So after exchange, you can block the pawn with your own knight. Correct. The question is this good enough? Yeah. Andro, you know this guy? Can you beat him? Why don't you play Fischer Random Chess with this guy and see... Because Fischer Random Chess is special. A lot of all that theory knowledge which separates the stronger players from the less strong players, it disappears, right? So Fischer Random Chess is the great equalizer, I like to call it that. So let's see... Probably weaker than Andro. Oh, we got another raid by St. Louis Chess Club. Thank you, St. Louis Chess Club. You guys are awesome. Thank you. Gentlemen, thank you so much. By the way, did the US qualifier end? Yes, I understand, because only Mark guys usually use banned. And etc. So is the US qualifier still going? Who got the spot for the US Championship? Anybody knows? Ah, still going. Okay. I see. Who is leading? Just three rounds in. Because I'm actually rooting for Dania and Elshan. Those are two of my good friends. Okay, I wouldn't call Daniel as my good friend but he is a colleague and okay, he's very friendly. We've been very friendly lately. All right, but Elshan, yes, is a good friend. You is leading. You? Who is you? Daniel is on 1.5 out of 3. What happened? My God, Elshan is 2 out of 3. Who is you? Elshan beat Hess. Ah, Robert. My God. By the way, did Robert... oh, Christopher, you? Oh, I remember this kid. He was... I remember that kid. Yeah. Yeah, but I never realized he had so much talent. Who is you is a philosophical question. Thank you, Mr. Cajun. Thank you for your gifting tier 1 subscriptions to 5 subscriptions. Who is me? Yeah, okay. Philosophical questions. Daniel lost to you. Yes, I would be very surprised at also. Yes, I was very surprised. Yeah, Danny should not lose to you, that's for sure. He can lose to him, that is a possibility, but losing to you... Losing to you is probably not the best idea, to be honest. Okay. Landerman is 2 out of 3. Also beat Tank. Tank is also playing, huh? Damn. That's one hell of a strong tournament, guys. It's a very strong tournament. And only one qualifier. Only one qualifying spot, yeah? Damn. I don't envy these guys. I mean, Dania played in the US Championships quite a few times. Elshan played once, right? And of course he wants to play more. I understand him completely. Robert also played a few championships. I'm not sure if he played more than a few. Okay, let's start pushing these pawns. Let's start pushing these guys. Swears, do you speak in Russian or English with Dania? In English, of course. I didn't know he spoke Russian, actually. Does he speak Russian at all? Never heard of him talking Russian, to be honest. Yeah, it's like a big surprise to me also to learn that Botez was half Russian. I didn't know that. I was like, wow. A lot of Russians, yeah? A lot of Russians. Yeah, but she is a Canadian, Russian, and Romanian, yeah? So, that combo is actually... It's, heavy stuff. Alright. Why does the background music sound like my go to sleep and wash away your anxieties? It does, yeah? It does sound like that. Okay. I'm sorry. It does sound like that. Yeah, because I like this relaxing, focusing music. You know, you have enough troubles in this world. This is soothing kind of soul music. Alright, let's go B4. I don't like this move, to be honest. I don't like this move, but I'm trying to keep this bishop on A2 closed. That's what I'm trying to do. He said he analyzed the game he played with Kramnik in Russian. I don't quite understand the last part, but it's okay. You are how sleeping with the boys. My gen request is being reviewed by team leader. What is your Lich Chess nickname, Mr. Random Moves? I'll add you right now. Is it the same? Wait. Oh, but okay. This is also. Damn. Alright. Random Moves, what is your Lich Chess nickname? Yes, but Mr. Gillett, you are not... you don't have a star, man. You need a star. You need to be a star, sir. Ah, Daniel Kramnik analyzed the game in Russian, I see. Okay, I didn't know that. Alright, let's see if Mr. Random Moves can be found. Doesn't say so. Nope. Can't find you, man. Yeah, the thing is, the problem is I'm also now a sort of moderator for the Van Duver chess team, so some requests are for the Open the Van Duver event, yeah? It's a little bit different. Okay. Fine, just play bishop d7. You can give up your bishop, yes. You can, you are allowed to trade your bishop finally, yes. No, not that kind of star. I was talking about the subscriber star. I mean, on Twitch, if you have the star, it shows that you're a subscriber. It has nothing to do with German's star. Besides, star is not... Come on, it's generic, right? It can be a star. Anybody can be a star. It doesn't have to be German. My god. Oh god. Alright, finally. Push the pawn. Still going strong. Yes, okay, trying to make this joke, but I'm just being very careful, man. Trying to be very careful. You guys, I'm not sure if some of you know it, but my League Chess streamer, official streamer, title was stripped away because I was doing too much of my thing, which is basically saying, this guy is a suspect, this guy is a suspect, oh, this guy is a suspect. The way you played is a very suspicious, man. So, you know, they took away the streamer title for that, and I'm like, and I was like, ugh. Yeah. Mr. Kez, okay. You realize there is a game called Drinking Chess, right? There is a drinking chess game. I'm not sure who invented this game. Probably it was one of these smart chess players. It was back in the 20th century, right? It was probably at some party with some girls, right? And some enterprising gentleman... basically, you know, the pawns are the smallest cups filled with, you know, sort of mild liquor, right? And then you have the higher the piece, right? The stronger liquor and the bigger the cup, right? So the smart guys, right? What they do, they sacrifice the queen like on the second or third move, right? Boom. That was the strongest move. Because imagine you have to drink this whole glass of this really heavy stuff, right? Yeah. You invented it? I really doubt it. You gotta be like at least 150 years old in order to invent that. I think it is like very, very old game. Yeah, drinking chess, right. So, Andrew and Chaos, you guys should play... You know what? You should actually play Bug House, invite some ladies, and offer them to play some drinking chess, and tell them you think they can be the next Elizabeth Herrmann, right? That's it. Easy. Your Wi-Fi cut? Alright, then you'll have to wait for the video to show up on the... if you're a subscriber, you can re-watch the video on the channel. All right. Uh-huh. Interesting game here. Yes. Yeah, interesting game. White has an open F file. Yeah. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, this is Fischer position. I'm not sure who is better, actually. I think... Black actually looks better in terms of long time structure, but in terms of the attack, white looks good, yeah? I think white should have played bishops. Bishop c2 or something, try to poke some weaknesses. That's why you give away the queen. Alright. Yeah, just don't give away the strong queen, right? The strong queen, the one that's really does everything, yeah? After all, it is the king who has to survive to win the game, right? Ha! Ha! I found my queen. I found my royal queen. I'm very happy. Yes. I'm very, very happy. Then, all right. Chess LeBron. Great. Okay. The viewers are better. I think our viewers are learning a lot of things, not only about chess, but about other aspects in life. Yes, some interesting new games, new variants of chess. Yeah, I mean, drinking chess is still a variant of chess. Yeah, it is. It's just probably not as well known, but yeah, it definitely existed in Dr. Elhine times. I remember. He, you know, remember, guys, he liked to drink, right? So when he was offered the game of drinking chess, I think he agreed immediately. I think he loved that game. Okay. All right, gentlemen, the arena is over. Thank you for staying for both the Fischer Chess and the Slav Botvinnik Arena. Let's go and raid some gentlemen. Twitch, chess, okay, who do we have, you can hear, day 13, Logitech, Command Twitter, Boaty, I have no idea what this is, Polish, English, Turkish, Spanish, Russian. Oh, by the way, guys, this is they do the commentary for the Russian Chess Championship, which is in progress, and they're doing it every day. So this team is in Russian, but I highly recommend you to go there. All right, I highly recommend it to for you to go there. So why don't we raid these guys? It is in Russian, but. Yes, Mr. Quadra, you could have joined. You are subbed, that is correct. Alright, good night everybody. And we are raiding.
И будет интересная борьба. А также у Леи Грифулиной есть реальный шанс вклиниться в борьбу за первое место, но для этого ей нужно совершать спортивный подвиг, нужно набирать как минимум 1.5 очка из 2 против таких соперниц, как Наталья Погонина и Александр Костенюк. Выглядит это, конечно, маловероятным, особенно с учетом того, что Наталья вообще хорошо играет с молодыми, с юными шахматистками, а Александр Костенюк... разыгралась, нашла свою игру и тоже претендует на медаль. Но опять же, тоже куча стыковых встреч. Ну,